What's up, guys? Let's talk about price to earnings or PE ratio and show you how to calculate it using real companies like Coca Cola and Pepsi. PE or price to earnings ratio is a financial ratio that helps you understand the stock's current price relative to its earnings per share. PE ratio, in combination with other financial ratios and price multiples, also help you determine whether a stock is overvalued or undervalued. PE ratio can also be used to establish comparisons amongst companies of similar size in the same sector or industry. The formula for PE ratio is the following. You simply take the share price and divide it by the earnings per share, or EPS. EPS then is calculated by dividing the net income minus preferred shares dividend, if applicable, over the common shares outstanding. EPS is also one of the most important figures to determine a company's profitability. Remember, when you buy a share of a stock, you're buying a real piece of that business. And effectively, you're buying a real piece of the earnings that that business produces. The good news is that PE ratios and earnings per share are already available for public companies. You can find them on financial websites like Yahoo Finance or Morningstar. To drive this concept home, let's take a look at Coca Cola and Pepsi and calculate the PE ratio for each. All right, here I have a Google Sheet to help us keep track of our data and keep everything organized. And on the right-hand side, we have Morningstar.com, which we're gonna be using to look up the stock information for Coca-Cola and Pepsi. By the way, I included a link to this spreadsheet in the description below. If you want to play with it, please make sure you make a copy before trying to make any changes. All right, so let's look up Coca-Cola first. All right, here we have the quote or the stock price for Coca-Cola. As you can see, the ticker symbol is KO. So I'm gonna type that over here. Obviously, you can access the stock price directly from this page. However, one nice thing about Google Sheets is that you can use the Google Finance option to look up any stock price in real time. So all you need is just, you need to call the Google Finance option and you need the ticker symbol. So I'm gonna reference the previous cell, hit enter. There we go. Now for earnings per share or EPS, we need to go to the financials. And they should be under the income statement over here. I'm gonna click on details view. Perfect. So here we have the income statement and I'm going to collapse all these rows until we get to basic EPS. And then I'm gonna scroll all the way to the right. And here we have the basic EPS for the trailing 12 months, or TTM, which basically means the last 12 months. Here you can see as well that we have a diluted EPS figure as well. Basically, what the diluted EPS means is that if all the stock options, warrants, or convertible bonds, if applicable, were to be exercised, then this would obviously mean that we have more total shares outstanding. So the EPS figure gets diluted a little bit because all of a sudden you have more common shares in circulation. So if the figure is available, some investors prefer to use the diluted EPS option because it's more realistic. However, in this case, we see that it's the same, so it doesn't matter. We're gonna just use 1.67 here. Perfect. And then the P ratio can be calculated by simply dividing the stock price by the earnings per share. All right, there we go. So we have a P ratio of 32.95. For Coca-Cola, let's do the same for Pepsi. Okay, so the ticker symbol is PEP. I'm gonna type that here. I'm gonna use the same approach. I'm gonna type for stock price, Google Finance, and then I'm gonna reference the ticker symbol. Perfect. And now we're gonna go to financials. Income statement. And here you can see actually a little bit the effect of dilution when you're looking at the diluted EPS. So if there are stock options, warrants, convertible bonds, or you know any convertible security, and if those options are exercised, then that means that you know the earnings per share, since we have more shares in circulation, would drop. Okay, difference here is minimal, but just to keep things consistent, I'm gonna use the basic EPS, okay? Actually, I can use the diluted EPS because for Coca-Cola, the basic EPS and the diluted EPS were the same. So let's use here 5.92. And then the P ratio can be calculated by dividing the stock price over the earnings per share. Perfect, so we have a PE ratio of 25.84 for Pepsi. Now that you have computed the PE ratio, what do you do with it? Is 20 a good PE ratio? Is 25 a good PE ratio? Is 50 a good PE ratio? Actually asking whether 20, 30, 50, 100 is a good PE ratio or bad PE ratio is the wrong question. PE ratios are simply another indicator that helps you value a stock. PE ratios should be only compared against companies of a similar size that operate in the same sector or industry. And typically you don't refer to PE ratios as good or bad. You refer to PE ratios as high or expensive PE ratios relative to the other companies in the same sector or industry, or cheaper or lower PE ratios in relation with similar companies in the same sector or industry. For example, the technology sector is known for having higher PE ratios as opposed to utilities or the financial sector, which are known for having lower PE ratios. Let me show you how you can look this up yourself. We're gonna go back to Morningstar, and I'm gonna click on markets. If I scroll down, you're gonna be able to see the Morningstar sectors or the sectors as classified by Morningstar. So for example, let's look at the sensitive category, and then if we click on technology, if we click on portfolio, basically you can see the sector as an index as well. You can see here that the technology portfolio has actually an average PE ratio of 26.9, almost 27. Okay. And if we go to, let's go to financial services here. Then you can see that the PE ratio or price to earnings ratio for this index that tracks the financial services sector is 13.92 or almost 14. So a lot lower than the technology sector. So if you're comparing P ratios of a technology company versus a financial company, in this case, that wouldn't be an apples to apples comparison. If you want to invest in a company with a high PE ratio, that means that investors are willing to pay a high price because they expect the company to considerably grow and increase their revenue year over year. So the expectation of higher returns is already built into the price of the stock. One limitation of the PE ratio that you probably noticed is that it relies on historical data and it doesn't take into consideration the future growth of the business. That's why investors also like to take a look at the price earnings to growth or PEG ratio. The PEG or PEG ratio can be calculated by dividing the PE ratio for the current period by the earnings per share growth for the next 5 years. The PEG ratio helps us answer the following question. Can we justify the stock price given the expected growth? Let's look at an example and plug in some numbers. If we have a PE ratio of 30 and an EPS growth or earnings per share growth of 15% for the next 5 years, then we would get a PEG ratio of 2. So as a general rule, most investors agree that the closer to 1, the better, which means that the price of the stock is justifiable given the expected growth. To wrap this up, let's go back to our Coca Cola and Pepsi examples and look up the PEG ratios. So I'm going to create a separate section here for the PEG ratio. Okay, perfect. We are on Pepsi already. So we're going to look at valuation. And here, if you look at the PEG ratio for 5 years, we can see that it's 322. Okay. And now if we go back to Coca-Cola, and we go to valuation, PEG ratio for the next 5 years is 3.87. Okay, great. So right now we have two indicators. We have the PE ratio and the PEG ratio for Coca-Cola and Pepsi. They're not the same size precisely, but they operate in the same sector and they have huge overlap across the products that they sell to the market. So if we look at the PE ratio, we see that Coca-Cola has a higher PE ratio. So basically you are paying more given the earnings per share for Coca-Cola than with Pepsi, or as opposed to Pepsi. And if you look at the PEG ratio, the one that's closer to 1 is actually the Pepsi PEG ratio. Okay? Not by much, but it's closer to 1 than Coca-Cola's PEG ratio. So based on this analysis, which again is an extremely incomplete analysis because we're using only two indicators, at least as of today, right now, Pepsi looks a better option, a better investment than Coca-Cola in terms of PE ratio and PEG ratios. We'll see in the future that once we start to look at other indicators and once we start analyzing things like the balance sheet, for instance, there's gonna be another things we wanna look at before actually investing in a stock. However, for purposes of this example, we could say that Pepsi looks the more attractive option. All right, I want to give you guys one final word of caution. Whenever you hear the words forward, expected, estimated, remember that you're dealing with projections that were most likely put together or estimated by an analyst or the company itself. So all the calculations and ratios and analysis that you do based on projected figures can only be as good as the projected figures themselves. That's why it is very important that when analyzing a stock, you look at many different signals and factors and not just at one or two indicators, especially if they rely on forecasted data. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. It would really help me if you please like and subscribe to my channel so that I can continue to make videos like this for you. Thanks for joining, and I'll see you next time.